Homecoming 2020. Tonight's game is a Lancaster-Lebanon League Section 2 matchup between the E-Town Bears and the Hovsgol Calico Eagles. This evening's halftime festivities will include the introduction of the homecoming court, followed by the crowning of the 2020 homecoming queen. The Lancaster-Lebanon League and Calico School District are emphasizing good sportsmanship from all coaches, athletes, and fans. This contest is being played for the benefit of the students and student-athletes of each school. No body paint, noisemakers, rally towels, signs, or banners are permitted. No fans are permitted on the track at any time. Calico is a smoke-free campus, and this includes vaping products. As of Friday, October 9th, amended COVID-19 orders allow for venue occupancy limits to play a bigger role in determining the number of people permitted both inside and outside of events or gatherings. An event or gathering is defined as a temporary grouping of individuals for defined purposes and times. This evening's game is included in that definition. Venues must require attendees to comply with 6-foot social distancing requirements, to wear masks or face coverings, and to implement best practices such as timed entry, multiple entry and exit points, multiple restrooms, and hygiene stations. All attendees must wear a face covering when entering, exiting, or moving around the stadium, and at least 6 feet of social distance from anyone not in your immediate family. Spectators in attendance are required to sit in the areas designated with blue tape so that we are able to ensure social distancing is occurring. Attendance at any event is subject to appropriate behavior and adherence to our health and safety plans. Anyone who refuses to adhere to our guidelines will be asked to leave. Thank you for your cooperation, and we do hope you enjoy the game. Ladies and gentlemen, sudden cardiac arrest is the leading killer of student-athletes in the U.S. each year. District 3 and the Peyton Walker Foundation have partnered to make SCA awareness a top priority this year. The foundation provides free heart screenings for students and athletes in District 3 schools to detect undiagnosed heart conditions in an effort to save young lives. Additionally, automated external defibrillators, machines known as AEDs, have proven to save the lives of those afflicted by sudden cardiac arrest. We ask your attention to the following statement. The nearest AED machine is located with the athletic trainer and in the large concession stand on the home side of the field. Thank you for your attention to this important matter. Wells Fan Sports Medicine wishes the Calico athletes a successful sports season. As the official health care and sports medicine provider for the Calico Eagles student athletes, we help them stay in the game. And we can do the same for all Eagles fans, because at Wells Fan Health, our goal is to help you reach your health goals on and off the field. So don't let orthopedic pain keep you on the sideline. Start your relationship with Wells Fan today. Learn more about our team approach to care at wellspan.org/Calico.
Thank you. Now, if you're in the action, you're going to try and get there. And I did connect that other mic after that. Oh, you might need to change that.
Here are tonight's starting lineups. First for E-Town and head coach Andy Burrell. Here are the offensive starters. At tackle number 74, William McGitt. At guard number 79, Jeff Kelly. At center number 69, Braden Brookholder. At guard number 50, Gavin Gray. At tackle number 78, Zachary Nicholl. Tight end number 80, Brandon Fowler. Outside linebacker, number 36, Austin Bang. Inside linebacker, number 6, Lou Engstad. Outside linebacker, number 34, Tyler Engstad. At safety, number 10, Bryson Flinton. Safety, number 4, Ethan Brown. At corner, number 22, Stephen Flinton. And the other corner, number 28, Casey Brunhard. Kicking duties tonight will be by number 1, Alex Mellinger. And the punting duties by number 7, Craig Neal.
Where's the sweatshirt?
Get off to sweat.
Yeah, well, it took 15 minutes.
Yeah. Well, yeah, maybe it's a break.
I keep it along the fence.
If able, please rise as the Cocalico High School Marching Band plays the Cocalico Alma Mater. Thank you. remain standing and remove your hats as we honor America and the servicemen and women who protect our freedoms with the playing of the national anthem. Town won the toss and deferred to the second half. They'll kick off to start the game. Deep to receive for Cook County will be number 10, Bryson Flinton. Number 22, Stephen Flinton. And number 28, Casey Bernard. Off for the Bears will be number 9, Chaz Maurer. Tackle was made at the 26-yard line where the Eagles start first and 10.
Come on, come on.
recovered for E-Town, 172, Justin Black. He's then brought down by number 52, Ben Behringer. Ball is placed at the Calico 26-yard line, first and 10, E-Town. Josh Rudy is sacked in the backfield. He's brought down by number 60, Nate Benton. Loss of 7 yards in the play brings up a second down 17. Is incomplete, intended for number 10, Patrick Gilholt. Broken up by number 34, Tyler Angstadt. Fourth down, 17. Pass intended for number 10, Gilholt. Bears turn the ball over on downs. So Calico starts first and 10 from their own 33-yard line. Mikey Ulysses. Tackle was made by Elijah Reitmeyer, number 13. Gain of 3 yards on the play, second down, 7. Line. Nash again, the ball carrier. Tackle is made by number 72, Justin Black. Eagles are in the Bear territory at the 49-yard line. Second down, four. Give us the number 20, Anthony Barrasso. Combining in the tackle, number 42, Robert Walters, and number 78, Zachary Lippold. Third down and two. Timothy Davis. 1 yard gain, third down eight.
Let's go, defense! Come on, boys! All right!
14-yard line. Fourth down of bounds by number 27, Thomas. Ball is placed at the 29-yard line. First and 10 for Calico.
Thank you.
Kicking off for Calico will be number 7, Craig Neal. Deep to return, number 21, Braden Cummings. And number 24, Kate Capello.
Come on, boy!
Off his return by number 21, Braden Cummings. Tackle is made by number 20, Anthony Barossa. Tackle is made at the 30-yard line, first and 10 Bears. Capello on the carry. Combining on the tackle, number 60, Nate Benson. And number 72, Damian Wolf.
Come on, boy.
No gain on the play, third down, 4. Capello is the ball carrier. Tackle is made by number 6, Luke Angstad. Gain of 7 yards on the play. Second down, 3. Covered for Calico by number 52, Ben Behringer. Recovery is made at midfield, first and 10, Calico. Walters.
Go, 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 go.
the play. Second down, four. Give again to number 20, Barrasso. Brock Belmont on the tackle. Game is enough for a Cook County goal, first and 10.
Come on, D! Head off!
At the 8-10, 37-yard line. Backfield. By number 54, J.R. Runnels. That's the end of the first quarter with a score for Calico, 7-0. Possession with a second down and 17. Anthony Barrasso, number 20 on the carry. Tackle made by number 20, Riley Drager. Ball is spotted at the 20-yard line of the Bears. First and 10 Eagles. On the carry, Walters, 42 on the tackle. Gain of 2 yards on the play, second down and 8. handoff is to number 36, Austin Vang. 44, Belmont on the tackle. Brings up a third down and two for Cocaligo. Carry forced out of bounds by number 42, Walters. There's a penalty marker on the field. Indication is holding against Cocaligo. Against Cocaligo. Replay third down. Third down and seven. Austin Vang on the carry. Number 54, Jonathan Riley Runnels on the tackle. Brings up a fourth down and five for Cocaligo. To number 22, Stephen Flinton. It goes 15 yards for the Eagle touchdown. Kicking off for Cocaligo will be number 7, Craig Neal. Deep to return for the Bears. Number 21, Braden Cummings. And number 24, Cade Capello. First and 10, Bears. Gives the number 22, Logan Lentz. He's brought down in the backfield by 52, Behringer. Loss of 3 yards in the play, second down 13. Josh Rudy on the carry. He's pushed out of bounds by number 8, Hirsch. Loss of a yard on the play. Brings up a fourth down and 14. In the punt for Etown will be number 27, Isaac Thomas. Number 10, Bryson Flinton, the return man for Procalico. Two Walters. Carson Nash, 16 on the carry. Walters, number 42 on the tackle. Gain of 4 yards in the play, second down and 6. Nash on the carry. Reitmeyer, number 13 on the tackle. First and 10 for Calico At the 27-yard line. Pitch is to number two, Micah Ulysses. Robert Walters on the tackle. Gain of 8 yards in the play. Second down, two. Nash on the carry. Reitmeyer on the tackle. Gains it up for Cook County. Go first and 10. Ball is placed at the 17-yard line of Newtown. Made by Timothy Davis, number 51. A loss of 2 yards in the play brings up a second down and 12. He's tripped up by number 19, McFarlane. Illegal procedure against Cocalico. Yard penalty repeats second down. He's second down and 17. Pass is incomplete. Intended for number 28, Casey Brunauer. Third down, 17. Stephen Clinton, 25 yards for the Cocalico touchdown. Alex Mellinger to attempt the extra point. for Calico will be number 7, Craig Neal. Deep to return. Number 21, Cummings. And number 24, Capello. Kickoff is returned by number 21, Braden Cummins. Number 36, Austin Bang, on the tackle. Officials timeout on the field. Pass is incomplete. Intended for number 4, Braxton Cicero. Second down, 10. Logan Lentz, number 70, Daniel Plump, in on the tackle. The loss of a yard on the play, third down and 11. Josh Rudy, number 5 on the carry, forced out of bounds by Clark, number 70. Gain of 3 yards on the play, fourth down 8. Isaac Thomas in to punt. Bryson Flinton, the return man for the Eagles. Okay. starts first and 10 at the Cocalico 47-yard line. Yards in the play, second down, 16. Penalty marker on the field. Dead ball offsides against E-Town. It will be a 5-yard penalty. Ball spotted at the 49-yard line of E-Town. First down and 5 for Cocalico. Tackle. Ball is spotted at the 13-yard line of E-Town. Barrasso on the carry. Lining on the stop, number 42, Walters, and 72, Black. Gain of 7 yards in the play, second down, 3. Defense! Nasham on the carry. He's in the end zone for the Cook County Good touchdown. Alex Mellinger to attempt the extra point. The extra point is good with 1:27 to play in the first half. Score Cook County goes 1-0. Kicking off for the Eagles will be Craig Neal. Deep to receive. Cummings, number 21. Capello, number 24. Kickoff is returned by number 24, Kane Capello. Number 4, Ethan Brown. And number 20, Anthony Barassa, combining on the tackle. Ball is spotted at the 10-yard line of E-Town. First and 10, Bears. Logan Lentz on the carry. Hit in the backfield by 52 Behringer and 70 Klump. The loss of a yard on the play brings up a second down and 11. Lentz on the carry, combining on the tackle, number 36, Vang, and number 70, Klump. Timeout, Tocaligo. Second to snap, one remaining. Toronto number 22, Logan Lent. Chucky Drain and Damian Wolf combining on the tackle. No gain on the play, brings up a fourth down and 11. Cocalico takes their third and final timeout of the half. Isaac Thomas. Return man for Cocalico is number 10, Bryson Clinton. Goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line of E-Town, where the Eagles start first and 10. Forced out of bounds by number 19, McFarlane, at 42, Walters. Ball is spotted at the 12-yard line of E-Town. First and 10, Cocalico. Flinton broken up by number 19, Elijah McFarlane. Second down and 10. Broken up at number 14, Brandon Lewis. Intended for number 22, Flinton. Alex Nellinger to attempt the field goal. Field goal is good. With 3 seconds to play in the first half to score, Cocalico 31, E-Town 0. the end of the first half. Play with the score for Calico 31, Elizabethtown 0.
Thank you.
Tonight we celebrate the time-honored tradition of homecoming at Coquelico. It is time to meet the young ladies that the class of 2021 has nominated to compete for the title of homecoming queen. The first candidate is Hannah Marie Custer. She is the daughter of Michelle and Jed Custer of Denver. Hannah is a member of the field hockey, basketball, and lacrosse teams. She is also active in National Honor Society and Leo Club. To prepare for a career in STEM, Ms. Custer has challenged herself by taking college prep courses including AP Calculus, Intro to Health Sciences, Intro to Forensics, and Anatomy and Physiology. Upon graduation, Hannah plans to attend the University of Richmond, where she will also play lacrosse. School aside, Ms. Custer volunteers by serving food to children through CrossNet, as a tutor for elementary students, and as a coach for youth lacrosse. In her spare time, Hannah likes to hang out with friends and family, play with her dog, read, and listen to music. Ms. Custer has chosen Noah Griffin as her escort. Mr. Griffin is the son of Stacy and Melanie Hope. The second candidate is Danielle Adora Drain. Danielle is the daughter of Carla Drain and Charles Drain III of Adamstown. Ms. Drain's goal is to become a teacher. She plans to earn a dual certification in early childhood education and special education, and then pursue a master's degree in special ed. Danielle has followed a college prep course of study, including AP courses in language and literature, as well as psychology and childhood development. Ms. Drain has committed to Mansfield University, where she will play Division II soccer. Danielle is a member of the varsity girls soccer and girls track and field teams, as well as the Functional Fitness Club and Leo Club. Danielle also plays soccer for PA Classics Girls Academy. Ms. Drain volunteers as a youth soccer coach and at Blessings of Hope, packaging food for families in need due to the pandemic. In her downtime, Danielle likes to draw, bake, play her brother in basketball, eat lots of food, work out at garage strength training, and spend time with family and friends. Ms. Drain's escort is Benjamin Beringer. Mr. Beringer is the son of Christine and Clark Beringer. Next we have Caitlin Hostler. She is the daughter of Jen and Eric Hostler of Reamstown. Caitlin enjoys photography, which includes taking senior pictures of her peers, going to greenhouses and gardening, enjoying time outdoors, and spending time with family and friends. Caitlin works at Dunkin' Donuts and as a babysitter. While in school, Ms. Hostler is preparing for a major and career in nursing by taking a college prep curriculum, including AP Biology, College Prep Chemistry, Intro to Health Science, Anatomy and Physiology, and Latin. Following high school, Caitlin plans to attend Bloomsburg University, entering into their nursing program to earn a Master of Science in Nursing. Escorting Ms. Hostler is Carson Nash. Mr. Nash is the son of Kara and Joe Nash. The next candidate is Jenna Michelle Crick. She is the daughter of Greg and Holly Crick of Adamstown. Jenna volunteers for a variety of activities through her membership in National Honor Society and Leo Club. She is a tutor at Denver Elementary and performs babysitting duties for the PTA. Jenna is also a member of the varsity field hockey team. Ms. Crick hopes to attend Alvernia, Penn State University, or Messiah College. In preparation, Jenna is challenging herself with college prep classes and advanced electives such as AP Calculus, AP Literature, Anatomy and Physiology, and Physics. When she has free time, Jenna likes reading, listening to music, watching Netflix, and hanging out with friends, family, and her dog. Ms. Crick is escorted by Gerald DeBalco. Mr. DeBalco is the son of Angela and Gerald DeBalco. Our next candidate is Quinn Rosato. She is the daughter of Sharon Rosato and Alejandro Rosato of Adamstown. You may see Quinn dribbling a soccer ball down a field for a goal or find her leading events for student government as the student government president. In addition to her leadership position in student government, Quinn is also the vice president of the senior class. Ms. Rosato has had the opportunity to volunteer at a variety of events, including Blessings of Hope and the Adamstown Holiday Activity. In school, Quinn enjoys visual arts and communications and is leaning toward a career in this field. To prepare, she has enrolled in Advanced Studio Art 2D and Independent Study in Art and Fundamentals of Art Online. Quinn is applying to Millersville University, Penn State Berks, and Westchester University to continue her education after graduation. Ms. Rosato's other interests include listening to music, spending time with friends, eating and sleeping. Quinn's escort is Carter Nunneville. Mr. Nunneville is the son of Kristen and Troy Nunneville. Our final candidate is Olivia K. Sansone. She is the daughter of Allison and David Mumov Stevens. Whether she is attending a fellowship of Christian athletes meeting or one for National Honor Society, Olivia is involved in school community. Ms. Sansone is also a member of the varsity field hockey team, the girls basketball team, and the girls track and field team. Through her membership in the National Honor Society, Olivia is a tutor at Denver Elementary and volunteers at the Declaration House in Denver. She is also an active member in her church, serving as a small group helper for third and fourth graders, and participates in youth group. When she wants to unwind, Olivia likes to spend time with friends and family, read, listen to music, and watch Netflix. Academically, Ms. Sensenick has followed a rigorous college prep regimen that also includes AP Biology, Physics, Anatomy and Physiology, and AP Calculus. Olivia plans to pursue a career in healthcare. Upon graduating, Olivia would like to attend Penn State University, Grove City College, Messiah College, Lebanon Valley College, or Ursinus. Olivia is being escorted by Brenton Sensenick. Mr. Sensenick is the son of Michelle and Ed Sensenick. From this brief introduction to the Calico Queen candidates, it is easy to see that each is smart, beautiful, and dedicated to academics, organizations, and athletics within the school. In short, each is well qualified for the title of Class of 2021 Homecoming Queen. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2020 Calico Homecoming Queen is Miss Danielle Drain. Congratulations to Danielle and the remainder of the Homecoming Court.
I don't know yet. I got a funny idea. I'm talking like
the counter's over there. Behind the bleachers.
Behind the bleachers on the other side of the fence?
Yep. Right here, go through here. Let's see it.
Oh yeah. Working on my Fitbit.
Where the RV is, one guy.
Yeah, I don't know what the last one.
hell's going?
Calico will be kicking off to start the second half of play. Kicking off for the Eagles will be number 7, Craig Neal. Deep to receive for E-Town will be number 13, Elijah Reitmeyer. And number 24, Cade Capella. Kickoff is returned by number 13, Reitmeyer. Number 5, Jacob Cole on the tackle. Ball is spotted at the 30-yard line of E-Town, where the Bears start 1st and 10. Logan Lentz with the carry. Stop is made by Bryson Flinton. Gain of 5 yards in the play, 2nd down 5. Drain, number 71 on the tackle. Gain on the play brings up a 3rd down 1.
That's 35.
So
this year.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she didn't even come back.
Oh.
She's not doing well with panic attacks. Uh-huh. She's just freaking her out.
Let's get on here, Harry. Gains enough for a 10. Luke Angstad, number 6 on the 10. Pass is complete to number 10, Gilhol. Initial hit for the Eagles by number 10, Clinton.
You just want to hold that, yeah.
He's in the Kukanika territory at the 47-yard line. First and 10, he's out. Thomas. Bryson Fletcher, the return man for Calico. Gibbs, number 20, Barasa. Robert Walters, 42 on the tackle. Gain of 2 yards in the play, second down and 8. Nash on the carry. Bradley Drager, number 20, and Braden Cummings, number 21, on the tackle. There's a penalty marker on the field. Indication is blocking the back against Calico. Yards from the spot of the foul, repeat third down. It'll be third down and 8. Gains it up for a Calico first down at their own 44-yard line.
Come on, defense!
Walters. Gain of a yard on the play, third down and 6. Elijah McFarlane makes the tackle. Tackle is made at the 42-yard line of E-Town. First and 10 Eagles. Number 79 on the tackle. Gain of 1 yard on the play, second down, 9. tackle for loss by number 79, Kelly. Brings up a third down and 17 for the Eagles. Defensive stop by number 14, Lewis. Gained about 3 yards on the play. Brings up a fourth down and 14 for Calico. And the punt for the Eagles will be number 7, Greg Neal. Return man, Kate Capello. 14-10. Catches made by Capello. Fair catch is made at the 14-yard line. That's where E-Town starts, first and 10. It's intercepted from the Eagles by number 28, Casey Bernard. Ball is spotted at the 33-yard line of E-Town. First and 10 Eagles. Is to Mike and Ulysses. He's brought down by number 20, Gregor. Gained about 7 yards of play. He's up a third down and 1 for Calico. Walters makes the tackle. Gain is enough to move the chains. First and 10 for Calico. At the 17-yard line. number two, Mikey Ulysses. He goes 17 yards for the Cocatico touchdown. Kicking off for Metallica will be number 7, Craig Neal. Return man for E-Town. Number 13, Elijah Reichmeyer. And number 24, Kate Capello.
Do you have the scoreboard off?
Kickoff is fielded by number 44, Brock Belmont. Stop is made at the 33-yard line of E-Town. First and 10 Bears. It's a false start against E-Town. It'll be a 5-yard penalty. See, first and 15. Reichmeyer on the carry. He's forced out of bounds by number 35, Blake Johnson. That's the final play of the third quarter. We head to the fourth with the score Cocatico 38, E-Town 0.
Thank you.
Number 22, Logan Lentz with the carry. Combining on the tackle, number 40, Jake Humphrey, and number 60, Nate Benson. Return man for Cocamico. Punt is returned by Clinton. Forced out of bounds by number 42, Walters. The ball will be spotted at the 40-yard line of Cocamico. They begin this possession at the 40 with a first and 10. To number 7, Craig Neal. Jet Kelly, number 79, makes the tackle. Gain of 2 yards in the play, second down and 8. Timothy Davis, number 51. Third down and 3. Tackle. Eagles are into E-Town territory at the 45-yard line, first and 10. Jacob Cole, number 19, McFarlane, on the tackle. Gain of 2 yards in the play, second down and 8. Walters on the tackle. Third down and 4. Handoff is to number 7, Neal. Walters again, number 42 on the tackle. Gains it up for Calico, 1st and 10. At the E-Town 33-yard line. Pitch on the play to number 26, Cole Boyer. Tackle is made by 54, Runnels. And a 2 second down 8. Penalty marker on the field. Face mask indicated against E-Town's 5-yard variety. 5 yards added to the end of the play. 1st and 10 for Calico at the 20-yard line. Davis, 51, makes the tackle. 5-yard gain, 3rd down 5. kickoff. 15 yards. Co-Calico will kick off from the 25-yard line. Kicking off for Co-Calico. Will be number 7, Craig Neal. Deep to receive for E-Town, number 21. Braden Cummings. And number 13, Elijah Reitmeyer. Begins this possession at their own 40-yard line. First and 10.
Thank you.
number 22, Logan Lentz. Number 29, Robbie Adams on the tackle. Stop was made at the 25-yard line of E-Town. They begin this possession, first and 10 from the 25. By number 32, Levi Behringer.
Are you still on?
I think you still have your Hawaiian shirt on. I had it off. told her I'm gonna wait to get the black. Maybe like a third or something. Kind of get better. Yeah, it got a little chilly up in there.